And that's why we have to ban political action committees, so people and corporations are put on the same level. And that's why we have to fight to ensure that the minimum wage, the presidential wage, and the congressional wage show we're all in it together. All together, and the closer, the better. That's where solidarity comes from. But let's not get fooled by the false populism that comes to us out of the very concentration of wealth and power that we're sworn to oppose. Outside of advertising, there is no such thing as a billion-dollar populist. Mr. Perot, we can afford to pay for our own democracy. We don't need you to lend it to us. And with these tools to democracy, we're going to move to higher ground and restore the promise of democracy. And then truly, we'll be able to fight trade treaties that reduce wages and weaken environmental standards. And we can fight to assure that every child has a decent education, and every family a decent house, and every single American the health care they deserve. And we can fight to see that we have an environment that isn't poisoned, but depends on clean, renewable energy that the people of this country make for themselves. Ours is the oldest party in the world, and whatever change had to be made in this country, in this century that is, it was made through the Democratic Party. But the real changes, the things that really shook things up, these came from below, from the people themselves. The Democratic Party gave us the Wagner Act in the 30s for working people, but it was only after brave men and women marched and picketed, even unto death, that that law went on the books. In the 60s, the Democratic Party gave us civil rights laws, but only after a courageous woman, Rosa Parks, refused to go to the back of a bus, and tens of thousands of ordinary people marched and protested and won against what was popular, even to the point of their own blood and even their own lives. And it's the Democratic Party today which stands behind the women of America in protecting their right to choose. But it was one woman, Anita Hill, who galvanized us all by standing up and speaking truth to power. And it's the Democratic Party which has the courage and the decency to champion in its platform the rights of gay and lesbian Americans. But only because courageous men and women were not afraid to talk back, act up, and call us to our better selves. Conventions and nominations are never endings, but only steps along the way. I intend to fight for this party, its ideals, tonight, tomorrow, this year, and every year, until together we overcome. I want you to join me in that undertaking. And as we join together in this spirit, no obstacle will stand in our way. Victory will be ours, because in our veins runs the blood of those at the darkest hour gave their lives so that this nation, under God, should have a new birth of freedom, and that the government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from this earth. We shall overcome, all of us together, working for what we believe. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, we wondered whether it would happen. It did not. No endorsement of the Clinton-Gore ticket from former California Governor Jerry Brown. We see his supporters there. Let's go down to the floor and Candy Crowley. Candy, you're amidst all of those supporters.